Okay. Good afternoon, Honorable Principal Madam, my esteemed colleagues and dear students. Today we have assembled on this virtual platform to celebrate this year's International Day of Biodiversity through a poster or PowerPoint presentation. Biological diversity not only envisages the wide variety of plants, animals, microorganisms, including genetic differences within each species, but also the variety of ecosystems like lakes, forests, deserts, agricultural landscapes that pose multiple kinds of interactions among their members, that is, humans, plants, and animals. Biological diversity resources are the pillars upon which our civilizations stand. Fish provide 20% of animal protein to about 3 billion people. Over 80% of human diet is provided by plants. Around 80% people living in rural areas in developing countries rely on traditional plant-based medicines for their basic health care. In spite of the growing realization that biological diversity is a global asset of tremendous value for future generations, the number of species is being significantly reduced by certain aggressive human activities. But one thing is certain, despite all our technological advances, we are completely dependent on healthy and vibrant ecosystems for our water, food, medicines, clothes, fuel, shelter, and energy. Sustainable development is the only way to ensure the well-being of the population inhabiting the earth as well as the well-being of the earth itself. Keeping this idea in mind, government leaders across the world came together to attend the Earth Summit in 1992 to construct a strategy for sustainable development In this summit, the Convention on Biological Diversity, in short CBD, was born, but it officially came into force on December 29, 1993. To commemorate its birthday, International Day of Biological Diversity was also celebrated in the month of December until 2001, when the United Nations proclaimed International Day of Biological Diversity to be May 22nd. Each year, this day focuses on a particular theme and is celebrated according to it. Presently, due to COVID-19, people are advised to celebrate this event online. This year, the theme is "We are part of the solution." The slogan was chosen to be a continuation of the momentum generated last year under the overarching theme, "Our solutions are in nature," which served as a reminder that biodiversity remains the answer to several sustainable development challenges. Biodiversity is the living fabric of our planet. UNESCO states that it underpins human well-being in the present and in the future, and its rapid decline threatens nature and people alike. To reverse this decline, it is important that we take up our role seriously. In order to do our humble bit to promote this event, we, the Bioscience Departments of South Calcutta Girls College, have taken up to organize today's program on the International Day of Biodiversity 2021 theme. I express my heartfelt thanks to all my colleagues and students whose overwhelming enthusiasm and participation behind today's program has made it a grand success even in this difficult time. Sincere gratitude and thanks are due to our Honorable Principal Madam Dr. Aparna Day, who, in spite of her extremely busy schedule, has made her presence possible in today's program. Her inspiration and much needed support has provided us with the necessary courage to conceive the idea of organizing this very program, particularly on a virtual platform. Now, without wasting any more of your time, I would like to request our principal madam to say a few words in this regard and inaugurate this program for all of us. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Good
madam.
afternoon to everybody.
Good
I
afternoon.
am very
Good afternoon.
happy to see such a prompt action from the part of my colleagues, faculty members, as well as from my students. It was not a week more when I requested to organize such a program. So, under this pandemic situation, all my colleagues and my dear students who have come forward to arrange such a program, I must express my thankfulness to them for their such prompt action. Now, Ahinshu has told many things, everything actually. So I have no more, nothing much more to say, but some of the points I would like to mention that on International Day of Biological Diversity, this effort, our effort, is to increase the awareness of significance of biodiversity for human life. The vital habitats now are being depleted due to encroachment on nature by us. So we have to re-examine and rethink our relationship to the natural world. In this context, I would like to mention the pioneer who introduced the movement, particularly the CIPCO movement, S. Bahuguna. We have recently lost her, with lost him in COVID, due to COVID. He was a pioneer in our country. So we must honor his way of approach to biological diversity, maintaining the biological diversity. It will be our tribute to him. The foundation upon which we depend in our and requirements, biological requirements, is nothing but a solution which is completely nature-based. Biological diversity resources are the basic units upon which we construct our society. So we have to maintain it for sustainable development. And due to the outbreak of COVID-19, under this pandemic, we are feeling it very much through our lives. So, to raise the awareness of this fact, we have arranged this program through the active involvement of the students. We have tried to involve our students through this online program. Hope the students will enjoy the program. And as the world responds to and recovers from the current pandemic, it will lead a robust plan. It will need a robust plan for protecting the nature. So we should keep in mind how to protect the nature in future so that the nature can protect humanity. So I will not elongate my lecture, and I would like to thank again all the faculty members whose tireless effort has made effort make this program feasible, and the students who have participated in this program must be benefited, and they will again participate in such programs. I hope so. And please, all of you, stay safe, stay at home, and enjoy the online programs besides your regular classes. Thank you all.
Thank you, madam, for your very inspiring and very informative speech. And yes, so it has been an irreparable loss that we have lost Sri Sundaralal Bahuguna, who was actually the pioneer in the Narmada movement and in the Chipko movement. Thank you, madam, for reminding us that. And with the words of inspiration from our principal, madam, we will now begin with our program. And Rajasri, it will be very nice if you could take over the stage from me and do the rest of the conduction. Thank you, madam.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Inshu. It's very encouraging, and your ma'am's inspiration and cooperation from the entire bioscience department that we were able to celebrate this or initiate this program. Now, without further delay, I would request Shruti Agarwal of Semester 4 Zoology Honours to speak a few words about this day. Shruti?
Good afternoon, respected Principal Ma'am, dear teachers, and everyone present here. Today, we have gathered to celebrate International Day for Biological Diversity 2021 to increase understanding and awareness of biodiversity issues. This year's theme is We Are Part of the Solution, which is a continuation of 2020's theme Our Solutions Are in Nature, which serve as a reminder that biodiversity remains answer to several sustainable developmental changes. We have a choice to make before it's too late. We can be part of the problem or we can be part of the solution. Despite all the industrial advances, we depend on nature and its biodiversity for our daily basic needs. It ensures that we have food, shelter, land, and is the very basic foundation of our livelihoods. Biological diversity resources are the pillars upon which we will build our civilization. But loss of diversity threatens all, including our health. It has been proven that biodiversity loss could expand zoonoses, while if we start to protect our biodiversity, it will provide us with excellent tools to fight against the various infections like the pandemic we are facing now. Biodiversity provides nature with its meaning. The beauty of the nature that we praise today is mainly because of the biodiversity conserving, and conserving it is very important. All across the world, the threat to biodiversity is increasing. Climate change, overpopulation, habitat destruction, pollution, introduced species, wildlife trade are a few of them. A report by UN states that around 1 million animal and plant species are now threatened with extinction. It also states that 3/4 of land-based environment and 66% of marine environment have been significantly altered by human actions. Plastic pollution has increased tenfold since 1980. Land degradation has reduced the productivity of 23% of global land surface. A report should be spread to aware the students and people of the society and protect the biodiversity even at the minimal level. Here is a list of few things that we can do to save biodiversity. We can avoid greenhouse gas emissions, use electronic devices as long as we can, segregate the waste and avoid the use of plastics, plant trees and treat them with utmost care, spread awareness using the various social media resources we have. At the end, I would like to thank our principal, Ma'am Dr. Aparna De, and the Bioscience Department of South Calcutta Girls College for organizing this event and contributing towards the awareness of the program. I would like to call RC ma'am to continue the program. Thank you.
Thank you, Shruti. Now coming to the main part, the poster presentation, I'll just display the effort of our students who have quickly arranged this poster presentation. Just a Second, I'll take a few minutes before presentation. Thank you.
Ma'am, am I audible?
Yes.
Yes, Rajshree, you're audible.
This is a presentation by the students, and I'll just scroll through it and ask some of our students to say some few words about their posters. Priyanka, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you want to say something? Divya and Rinkina, Nisha. Kasturi, your presentation, please.
Yes, ma'am. I'm ready. A very good afternoon to my respected teachers and my dear friends, and also the principal. I am Kasturi Roy, a fourth semester from the Department of Zoology, and today, on the International Day of Biodiversity, I will be presenting this poster on behalf of my team, which includes two of my fellow classmates, Shahina Rahman and Sayeda Uma. My topic for today is biodiversity conservation through agroforestry. Before I get into the types of agroforestry, I would like to highlight the importance of biodiversity. Our food and medicine systems rely on ecosystem services, but agricultural biodiversity is declining. Only plant species account about 66% of the total crop production. Genetic diversity on farms improve crop adaptability to local conditions, making plants more resilient to pest, disease, and climate change. Planting a wide variety of crops supports healthier diets, leading to better nutrition and less reliance on a limited number of crops. Reducing pesticide helps maintain pollinator population. 75% of our food producing plants depends on bees, bats, and other pollinators. Intact and dynamic ecosystems help to increase resilience to the climate change by maintaining the ecological balance. Heading to our poster, agroforestry is a collective name for land use systems and technologies where woody perennials are deliberately used on the same land management units as agricultural crops or animals in some form of spatial arrangement or temporal sequence. The three kinds of agroforestry discussed are agri-silvicultural systems, silvopastoral systems, and agro-silvopastoral systems. And moving then, some of the important benefits of the system, which are: agroforestry provides ways to eliminate deforestation and land depletion and thus reduce poverty. It combines growing trees and along with agriculture or livestock or both. Agroforestry is usually practiced with the intention of developing a more sustainable form of land use that can improve farm productivity and welfare of rural community. Precisely, Agroforestry is one such method of biodiversity restoration, but we must keep in mind that while doing restoration work, we must not forget to conserve existing forests, reduce our carbon dioxide emissions, as well as to save the rich wildlife of our planet. Thank you.
Thank you. Nandini Ram, second year semester 2 zoology honors. I would request Muskan, she wants to explain her poster.
Good afternoon to everyone. Today, I am Muskani Tahira, 6th semester, Department of Zoology. I'm here to explain my poster. The heading of my poster is It's in Our Hands. Now here, I have drawn an Earth. This is the planet on which we reside. And the Earth has hands on both the sides. The Earth has a landmass which I am depicting here as hands. The hand has animals, different species of animals, which means the earth is totally biodiverse. Different varieties and variabilities of genetic species and ecosystems reside in this planet. And here is one Hercules, a Titan god from the Greek mythology, is represented who is carrying the earth. Here he is representing the human who is holding the earth and controlling the earth. Even after we are facing the pandemic, my main motto is to say the word that please protect the biodiversity for us and also for the future, because time is running out and we should do it before the time at last runs out. Thank you.
Thank you, Muskan. Srija wants to go green and maintain the ecosystem. Shogata has worked on the industrial pollution and with this, I come to the end of the just poster presentation. It's a short program.
Ma'am?
Yes?
Ma'am, we have a presentation, so.
Yes, you can.
Ma'am, we just want to say a few words about our poster.
Okay. Which poster?
Ma'am, oh mother, we all are together.
Have you seen the number?
Ma'am, that the yellow one. Scroll up once. Ma'am, that yellow one, yes, ma'am.
Didi 21.
Yes, ma'am, this one. Should I start?
Yeah, welcome. Yeah, welcome.
Thank you, ma'am. Good afternoon to all the teachers, our respected principal ma'am, and our friends present here. Today, we are here to present our poster for the intra-college quiz and poster presentation. The poster is made on the topic, we are the part of the solution. As we can see in the poster, we have mentioned various different ways how we can save our mother. It is the responsibility of every individual to protect the nature as we are almost on the edge. It is a now or never kind of situation now. And to protect our nature, we need to plant more trees, save water, as the level of pure drinking water is decreasing day by day. We can also save water in various different ways, like doing the top white knot in use, practicing rainwater harvesting, etc. We should also conserve wind energy by placing windmill and convert them as per requirement. We should also use disposable bags and water bottles and give up on plastic, as nothing harms our mother more than plastic. We should also need to use separate dustbins and dispose our waste accordingly, that the degradable waste can be recycled and electronics and plastic wastes are disposed separately. Last but not the least, as we all know, the whole world is fighting with a deadly virus, and in this pandemic, every individual is at a distress. But we must need to maintain 6 feet distance if we are out for an emergency or necessity. By doing this, we will emerge successful before long. We all know that nature has its own resources, and since before, forever, we have depleted that. If by doing this, we all can help our mother, then it would help us for the long run and the generation upcoming. So let's give a faith to ourselves and to our planet. Oh, mother, we all are together. Thank you.
Ma'am, I'd like to say something about my poster.
Which poster?
Ma'am, let's save the nature together.
Can you tell the number?
I think it's 19.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am, this one. Good afternoon, everyone. I, Durba Das, would like to share my thoughts about my poster. Let's save the earth together. Our planet and its resources make life possible on it. Without these resources, it is impossible to imagine life on Earth. But with the increasing level of pollution, these resources are either getting destroyed or depleted recklessly. It is very difficult to create a sustainable future in order to survive on it, and we need to start taking measures to save it. We must understand the resources that are provided by the Earth are limited. However, the majority of us are unaware of this fact, and we are not judiciously utilizing the resources. In order to safeguard the existence of humans, we need to protect the Earth and take care of it. Therefore, saving the Earth is the primary need, and we should make conscious decisions to make the Earth a better place and sustainable place to live in. Thank you.
Is there anyone else who want to speak about her or explain her poster? Because we were all in a hurry and we received poster late at night till 12:30. Is there anyone else who want to explain her poster? So I think there's no one else, and I'll stop the presentation with it. Thank you, girls, for your effort. You were very efficiently, you did this thing, this presentation. And now I would request Muskan of semester 6 to say a few words, or she wants to share her views about this day, especially the biological conservation of biological diversity. Muskan, are you there?
Yes, ma'am, I'm there. Am I visible?
Yes.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Good afternoon to my respected teachers, dear friends, and my lovely juniors. Our planet's diverse, thriving ecosystem may seem like permanent fixtures, but they are actually vulnerable to collapse. Jungles can become deserts, and reefs can become lifeless rocks. Even without any catastrophic events like volcanoes, asteroids, or cyclones. Now the question here arises that what makes the ecosystem so strong? The answer is biodiversity. Biodiversity is the measure of variety of life on Earth, being it in ecosystem or species or genetic ones. Biodiversity is mainly built out of three intertwined features, which are ecosystem diversity, species diversity, and genetic diversity. Look closely at nature. Every species is a masterpiece, exquisitely adapted to the particular environment in which it has survived. Who are we to destroy or even diminish the biodiversity? Well quoted by E.O. Wilson. For example, take the example of Amazon rainforest. One of the most biodiverse regions on this planet. Due to its complex ecosystem, huge mixtures of species and genetic variety within the species occurs. Over 3 million species live in the rainforest, and over 2,500 tree species approximately are present there, which are discovered till date. India is a subcontinent and also one of the most biodiverse regions in the whole world, accounting for about 96,000 species of animals and about 45,523 species of plants. Now, the history of this day. The United Nations has proclaimed May 22nd as the International Biodiversity Day to increase understanding and awareness of biodiversity issues. When first created by the Second Committee of the UN General Assembly in the late 1993, 29th December was taken into account. In December 2000, the UN General Assembly adopted the 22nd May as the International Day for Biological Diversity. To commemorate the adoption of the text of the Convention on 22nd May of 1992 by the Nairobi Final Act of the conference for the adoption of the agreed text on biodiversity, the main standards of biodiversity. Now, in order to understand the issues regarding biodiversity, we must address the reasons which are threatening it and causing its destruction. Out of all reasons, a bunch of reasons, biodiversity is mainly affected by deforestation, habitat destruction, introduced invasive species, which can be human as well as naturally like water hyacinths, genetic pollution, over-exploitation of resources, the natural resources, mainly the non-renewable sources of resources, then hybridization, climate change, disease, and human overpopulation. So from these mentioned causes, we come to a conclusion that the species which are most responsible for threatening biological diversity and destroying to an extent is Homo sapiens. That is, we humans, which leads to truly adopting the slogan, we are part of the solution for this special day. We celebrate this day to raise global awareness about the importance of protecting biological resources and the global biodiversity that shapes our lives as well as our own lives. So I would like to say that it is our duty and responsibility to protect the biodiversity, not only for maintaining the ecological balance or for maintaining the species count or numbers in the world, but there is no planet B available to us, and also for the future generations to come. I would like to end my speech with a quote by Thomas Isner. He said that biodiversity is the greatest treasure we have. Its diminishment is to be prevented at all costs. Thank you and have a nice day.
Thank you, Muskan. Now I would ask, request Chandrani on behalf of other semester 6 honors, zoology honors students to present her poster, which I missed out. Please hold on for a few seconds.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes,
this is Jayanti from Serial 8.
Excuse me, Pavali, you said something.
Yes, ma'am, this is there in the serial number 8, your poster.
Yeah, okay. Chandrani, are you there in the group?
Yes, ma'am.
Please explain.
Ma'am, আমাদের পোস্টারের মাধ্যমে আমরা এটাই বোঝাতে চাইছি যে আমরা যেমন একদিক দিয়ে ডিস্ট্রয় করতে পারি আমাদের বায়োডাইভার্সিটিকে, তেমন আরেকদিক থেকে আমরা সেটাকে রিভাইভও করতে পারি। সুতরাং আমাদের ইগোয়েস্টিক না হয়ে আমাদের নেচার এবং বায়োডাইভার্সিটি যাতে সংরক্ষিত হয় সেটা আমাদের দেখা উচিত, এবং আমাদের কাছে একটাই আর্থ রয়েছে, সুতরাং সেটাকে ওয়েস্টে দিতে যাওয়ার কোনো মানে হয় না। তাই আমরা যেরকম একদিক দিয়ে পার্ট অফ দ্য ডিস্ট্রাকশন, আবার আরেক দিক দিয়ে পার্ট অফ দ্য সলিউশন।
Thank you, Chandrani and others. Now, thank you for your cooperation. Now I would ask or request Ronnie to end the program.
Good afternoon, everyone. Before extending my gratitude to everyone here, I would like to draw some attention towards today's session. There is an indissoluble connection between nature and human life. So we are dependent on healthy, diverse natural system for our food and health to a staggering extent. Therefore, 22nd May has been observed as the International Day of Biodiversity to raise awareness about several biodiversity issues. To save ourselves, it is necessary to conserve nature. It is an urgent requirement. Therefore, this day is celebrated to thank nature for what all brings us to us. The biodiversity that we see today, it is the evolution from billions of years of fruits, which is shaped by natural processes and increasingly by the influence of humans. On this day, the whole world, various events are organized to make people understand the importance of biodiversity and what role it plays for a future. The theme for today's year is we are a part of solution for nature, underscoring that we can all be powerful agent for the positive change of people and planet. So today we all gathered together to be a part of this celebration to thank our Mother Nature. I would like to thank our principal madam for encouraging us to organize a program for this great cause. Though this is a terrible pandemic platform for carrying out this program, I would like to extend my gratitude to every student who cooperated and came forward to participate in the quiz and the poster presentation to make this event successful. Also, a big thank you to Dr. Rajushree Chakraborty, Ms. Chandrima Bhattacharya, Dr. Pubali Mitra, for their tremendous effort to organize this program. Indeed, no event can be carried out without people who dedicate their time to make sure that everything is properly executed. Apart from this, I would like to thank all the other teachers of Bioscience Department for their kind cooperation. And last but not the least, a good audience deserves a proper gratitude as well. So my heartfelt thanks to everyone, all the teachers of various departments for sparing time to attend this program, and also all the students who have been part of this event on biodiversity. It's worthwhile to mention here that an integral part of this biodiversity, we humans have the prime responsibility of being health conscious. So keeping in mind the devastating pandemic we are going through, it is my humble request to everyone to please stay safe and carry out every precautionary measure to protect ourselves. Thank you. So I would like to hand over the session to Rajshree to end this session.
Thank you, Ronnie. I would request Dr. Banibrata Das to conclude this session with his small thoughts about this quick program. Banibrata, are you there? Yeah, you are there. Banibrata, are you there? I can see him. Yes. Without you, the program will be incomplete. Bioscience will be incomplete.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, you are very much audible.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. First, I want to congratulate all the participants for initiative to take that such a wonderful program for the biodiversity. And I want to thanks to Principal Ma'am to give the permission to do that program. And I am very much good to see to the students' participation in different aspects of biodiversity. And some of the students has given the good, very good experience about the different parts of the biodiversity. I thank to everyone and all over the biological department to participate to organize such programs. Thank you all. Rajushree.
Thank you, Manipratha. Ma'am, I would like to finally thank you with a big thank you to you and to all our teachers and faculty members and students that with small effort, we had tried to arrange this program, and there are lots of flaws in it because we couldn't make out that some students would like to explain their poster, but still we managed it. And I think so you'll pardon us for this delay and some of the problems we had faced during this presentation. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you all. Thank you, students. With that, I end this program, and I ask permission of Principal Ma'am so that we can end this program.
Ma'am? There is no question of pardon because your earnest effort and prompt action really deserves the acknowledgement, and I must acknowledge our students. I must acknowledge the effort of our students who have so promptly responded in our call. So I think it's the success of the total South Calcutta Girls College family, not only the bioscience department, but also the students from other departments like geography, journalism and mass communication. I have seen all the posters, and this inclusiveness is the, this togetherness and inclusiveness is the main thing, main outcome of this program. So thank you all. And again, we hope under this pandemic, we will be able to be together in such programs, through such programs. Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, madam.
I would also thank Shentu also, because he couldn't help us through his using his laptop, but he guided us, especially Chandrani and Chonjima and Pubali, to how to do these things, arrange the posters and like make a flyer, because Shentu is a person who does all these things, but this time he guided Chandrima, and we could make it. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you all. With that, I end this session. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.